Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It is about understanding. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about arcs and chords theorem. So what could be the objectives? First, we will identify the arcs and chords theorem. Second, we will measure the arcs and chords theorem. And then the third one, we will apply arcs and chords theorem. Theorem 1, congruent arcs and congruent chords. If letter E, that is congruent arcs, have congruent chords, so if arc EG is congruent to arc MS, then segment EG is congruent to segment MS. Letter B, congruent chords have congruent arcs, so it means segment EG is congruent to segment MS, then arc EG is congruent to arc MS. Example, in the diagram, if segment EG is congruent to segment MS, then arc EG is congruent to arc MS. So if arc EG is equal to 80 degrees, so it means arc MS is also equal to 80 degrees. In the given, segment EG is equal to 8y minus 1, and segment MS is equal to 15y minus 15. If segment EG is congruent to segment MS, so it means the measure of the segment EG is equal to the measure of the segment MS. So segment EG, let us copy, and then the segment MS, let us copy, and then let us combine like terms. So bring down 8y. Positive 15 going to left, that is negative 15y, addition property of equality, and then equals, bring down negative 15, negative 1, change the sign, that becomes positive 1. 8 minus 15, subtract, that is negative 7y, negative 15 plus 1, subtract, that is negative 14. Let us divide both sides by negative 7 to solve for y. So negative 7 divided by negative 7 is y. Negative 14 divided by negative 7 is positive 2. And then let us solve for the segment EG. So that is equal to 8y minus 1. So let us replace y by 2. So 8 times 2 minus 1. 8 times 2 is 16 minus 1. The answer is equal to 15. Segment EG is equal to 15. Automatically, without solving, segment MS is also equal to 15 because segment EG is congruent to segment MS. So let us proceed to theorem number 2. A diameter that is perpendicular to a chord, and also the diameter bisects the chord and arcs with two equal parts. It means in circle T, segment SE is the diameter, and segment GM is a chord. So it means if SE is perpendicular to GM, so this one is perpendicular, then GR, segment GR, is congruent to segment RM. And also, arc GE is congruent to arc EM. In circle T, segment GM is perpendicular to segment ES. So let us find the segment ES if the measure of the segment ER is equal to 10 cm. So what could be the solution? Segment measure of the segment ER is equal to the measure of the segment RS. So it means if ER is equal to 10 cm, so the segment RS is also equal to 10 cm. So let us identify the segment ES. So we need to add the segment ER plus the segment RS. So segment ER is 10 cm. So the segment RS is equal to 10 cm. 10 plus 10, the answer is equal to 20 cm. So segment ES is equal to 20 cm. So let us find the value x, arc GE, and arc GM. If arc GE is equal to 8x minus 5 degrees, and arc EM is equal to the quantity of 3x plus 10 degrees, so it means arc GE is congruent to arc EM. So the solution, the measure of the arc GE is equal to the measure of the arc EM. So 8x, the quantity of 8x minus 5 degrees, and the quantity of 3x plus 10 degrees. If we divide both sides by 1 degree, so it means that becomes 8x minus 5 and 3x plus 10. So para mas madali nating masolve yung x. So combine like terms, so tanggalin na natin yung degree dito. Let us combine like terms. If we combine like terms, that becomes 8x. Positive 3, change the sign, that becomes negative 3x. Bring down 10, negative 5, change the sign, that is positive 5. 8 minus 3 is equal to 5, copy x. 10 plus 5 is 15. To solve for x, let us divide all by positive 5. So 5x divided by 5 is equal to x. 15 divided by 5, that is equal to 3. Afterwards, let us solve for the arc GE. So the arc GE is the quantity of 8x minus 5 degrees. So let us replace x by 3 to the given equation. So that becomes 8 times 3 minus 5 degrees. Another, the quantity 8 times 3 is equal to 24 minus 5. And then 24 minus 5, we need to subtract. So that is equal to arc GE is equal to 19 degrees. If arc GE is equal to 90 degrees, automatically, the measure of the arc EM is equal to 19 degrees. So let us identify the arc GM. So arc GM is equal to GE, arc GE plus arc EM. So arc GE is equal to 19 degrees plus arc EM is equal to 19 degrees. 19 plus 19 is equal to 38 degrees. So arc GM is equal to 38 degrees. So let us practice what you have learned about the arcs and chords theorem. Instruction, given the circle R, identify the value of X, chords, and arc. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.